Hello folks, we are now up to part 6 of this tutorial series on writing a simple VST plugin host application in C++. In the first episode, I laid down a plan, listed the objectives of the project, and here it is again. So let's see what has been accomplished so far. Display plugin particulars. Yes, that was done right at the beginning. Then we talked about the structure of a MIDI file, and root code to read it. And then came the most crucial part of the project, namely to work out how to process MIDI events data and get a plugin to generate audio output. Initially, that output was written to a WAV file, and that file could be played with an audio player or media player. The next challenge was to write program code to play the audio in real time, as it was generated by the plugin. Before proceeding with the next two items on this list, in this tutorial I just want to pause for a few minutes and make a couple of changes or improvements to the program. So far it has been run in the development environment, which is in my case Visual Studio. To make it more useful, I want to turn it into a command line application with a syntax like this. Plugin is the name and path of the plugin. And I put WAV file in square brackets because it's an optional parameter. To satisfy this requirement, the noteworthy change in the program is the addition of this parse command line method. It's supposed to be fairly simple, although somewhat tricky to implement because of all the conditions that need to be taken into account. I'm using this Windows-specific getFileAttributes function to check if a file can be opened, which is probably not the best solution, but it will do until I find a better one. A word of caution if you are using Windows Media Player. Windows Media Player doesn't release the file you played with it, so if your program tries to overwrite the same file, it will fail. You first need to close the player. What I want to show you now is that in order not to duplicate code, I created a device parent class and two subclasses, audio device and WAV device. We already had the audio device class and it hasn't changed, except now it is a subclass of device. The play audio stream method is now a virtual function in device and it is implemented in the audio device class. WAV device is a new class and it also implements the play audio stream method, but rather than sending the audio output to the computer's audio interface, it writes to a WAV file. This structure, this inheritance relationship, now enables us to call playMIDITune with either an audio device or a WAV device as an argument, and in playMIDITune, the code can remain the same as before. Notice that a song is played twice with a break of 1 second in between. And that brings me to the next subject in this video. When I tested various melodies with different plugins, I found that sometimes the very last bit of a tune is cut off. And strangely enough, it gets played at the beginning when I run the program again. In an earlier video, I already mentioned that in the loadData function, I added this line in order to prevent cutting off the very end of a tune. In this version, I also made some changes to the exit condition of the while loop. I introduced a new static variable, finished, which is false when loadData is first executed and becomes true when both these conditions, MIDITune at end and MIDI event elapsed, are satisfied. When finished is true, the flags variable is set to this value to indicate to the caller that processing has completed. In the previous version, I also filled the buffer with zeros, which is silence, but now I moved that into the while loop in play audio stream. Now I'm going to execute the program from the command line. I already compiled it and copied it to a flash drive together with the MIDI test files to avoid those long path names I would have had to type in if I was on my C drive. So each tune we'll play twice with a brief break between them. Listen for the kind of flow I mentioned earlier. No problems here. This next tune is more interesting. Did you hear the momentary sound before the melody began to play the second time? It can be eliminated if I increase the processing time. Here, but I'm not sure if that's the right way of doing it. To go out, I play a few more tunes, but this time without repeats.